Let's see what you got. I've seen lots of bodies like this one being carted off in my time. I can say he was shot in a single glance, but even you figured out that much, right? With your current gun laws, it's not exactly easy to get your hands on a gun. Not unless you're a member of law enforcement like Officer Meekins, isn't that right? That's your argument? That is your reasoning? Solid as rock. It's based on the philosophy of detainment. What's this philosophy of detainment? Ha! You don't know? In that case, pay attention, girly. In my country, the criminals have a saying, beware of the wolf. Why the wolf? Because in my language, Lang means wolf, and you don't mess with me or my pack. Oh, how fitting. So that's your pun. Ah, soda. And as long as, and as for the detainment philosophy, it's my father and my honorable ancestors, Lang Z. You'd think I'd have heard of him and his teachings if he's that famous. Random. Lang Z developed it as he worked to lock criminals away thousands of years ago. To this day, the Zhang Fu police still trains its recruits using his philosophies. But thousands of years ago, that makes your story sound as believable as a fairy tale. Anything wears down and breaks over time. Do you really believe something as ancient as that can be applied to today's world? You wanna put it to a test? Rebuttal. Xilong Lang's logic. That's pointless for now. Let's press this because I can. If that's the case, there are plenty of other officers who might be potential suspects. You're not seriously going to arrest each and every one of them, are you? As if I would need to. I've already looked into everyone else here. Oh. Other than Officer Meekins, I know no one else. I know no one else's weapon has been fired. How did you check every single person's weapon in such a short span of time? That's because each and every one of my subordinates is extremely capable. It didn't take more than a few minutes to conduct the entire investigation. The power of sheer numbers. But you have yet to check Officer Meekins' weapon, correct? Thanks for reminding me. Hey you, show me your gun! Oh! What's wrong? Why does he look so sickly pale all of a sudden? Gun? What did you say? I can't hear you. Stop mumbling and spit it out already. Sir? Sir? I lost my gun, sir! How could you be so irresponsible? Great, so he lost his gun. How fitting. In the end, it looks like you're still the only suspect we've got. You're the only one who waited out here outside this garage to ambush and kill the victim. So you think that Officer Meekins waited here to kill the victim, do you, Lang? I think this little accusation deserves a lot more scrutiny. Knew it! It's not in the garage where the crime was committed, sir. Unfortunately for you, Agent Lang, that is simply not possible. What do you mean? You've seen the crime scene for yourself. And while you were looking, did you not think to yourself that it was a little too clean? Yeah. So you did not notice there was too little blood? Do you still wish to claim that Officer Meekins committed the murder here? Because this isn't the crime scene, and if it was your men who led you to think it was, then I suggest you leave this case to the local police to set the record straight. Yeah. Quit laughing. Not bad. I see your logic can be just as sound as mine. In that case, let me ask you this. Don't you think it's weird that officer was hanging around here in the first place?
Weird? How so?
Hey, you. Your squad's not even supposed to be in this area, right? What were you doing neglecting your duties and loafing around here?
I...
Don't you dare give me some lame excuse like I found myself taking a walk.
But sir, I really did take a walk, sir.
You're a disgrace. How dare you take your pack obligation so lightly?
Officer Meekins is looking extra meek. Is he hiding something?
Mr. Edgeworth, please, sir!
Save me! Save me the way you did earlier! Please, sir!
Officer Meekins, please give us a detailed account of what happened.
Sir, not you too!
Oh god, it's Officer Meekins' rebuttal. It's his testimony. Oh god.
It's true, sir! I wasn't assigned to this area, sir! I was told to check every square inch of the main gate area, sir! I also went looking for the kidnappers while selling dreams in the blue bathroom mobile, sir! But I got completely caught up in my role selling dreams to children, sir! Before I knew it, I found myself here in this area, sir!
What is this blue badger mobile?
It's a moving store on wheels that sells sweet dreams and merchandise, sir!
So the blue badger mobile is just a roaming souvenir shop?
Oh, sweet!
Add it down to the organizer.
Sir, I swear I was chasing the kidnappers down while I was being a good dream merchant.
He seems rather worked up, even more than his usual hyperactive self.
He sure seems sure of whatever he's saying.
Can you try to calm down and lower your voice a little more to a more responsible level, officer?
Sir! Roger, sir!
Rebuttal. Meekins' testimony.
Let's see. It's true. I wasn't assigned to this area, sir.
Hold it!
I'm curious. Alright, then what were you doing? What were you assigned to?
I was assigned to the main gate, sir.
He must mean the area with the bridge and the outrageous fountain.
Okay, then why are you here in the Wild Wild West area?
Okay, that doesn't explain stuff, does it? Describe for me how you conducted your investigation.
Yes, sir. Well, first I made sure there was no suspicious-looking people in the area, sir. But the only people that seemed to gather around me were little girls, sir.
Well, what did you expect when you're dressed like the Blue Badger?
I thought I had no choice at that point, sir, so... I also went looking for the kidnappers while sons.
Okay.
What exactly do you mean by selling dreams?
Oops.
Huh. Sweetness like you've never known except in your dreams, ma'am.
Bitterness found only in nightmares, ma'am, like guilty jawbreakers. Selling those as I push the blue badger mobile along is my sworn duty, ma'am.
Jeez, why don't you get a life? Okay. I'm curious, why didn't you leave? How did you wind up all the way over here?
I was in the middle of a sea of kids, sir. One of the kids decided to challenge me to a fight, sir.
What?
I had to run away from the shot's painful drop kicks.
Good old drop kick. I dished out my fair share of those when I was a kid. It was always the best when you felt one really connect with your opponent.
In any case, you wound up here for a reason completely unrelated to the investigation.
Sir!
That's right, sir.
That's not something you should be admitting to with your head held high, officer. There is? There's a flaw? This is the only thing I didn't press, but after this I'll start looking for contradictions. You can't believe I forgot to look for the kidnappers. Yes, you would. Meekins, you would forget. I know you. Okay, well, I've only seen you in Apollo, but still.
Why, you're good at this forcing people to confess thing, Mr. Edgeworth.
I know it's not you, because you have to show up in Apollo Justice, so you can't get arrested. Let's see. No.
Objection!
Oh, found it. Knew it. Okay, got it. Finally.
Officer Meekins, I would appreciate it if you didn't tell such transparent lies.
Sir, I'm lying, sir?
Yes, you are. If you were really out there selling dreams with the Blue Badger Mobile until recently,
Then what is it doing here inside the garage? Ah, that's not creepy, that's just funny.
Actually, I just lost track, sir.
Lost track of what?
By the time I realized the blue Batmobile was nowhere to be found, sir.
Which would mean it was perhaps stolen.
And that's when I came back to this area, thinking maybe it was in the garage, sir. But that's when you found me, Mr. Edgeworth, sir.
A likely story. Who do you think is going to buy such a convenient tale as that? And what exactly is so convenient about his story? That car getting stolen is completely unbelievable, even for a cover story. But I think we can assume the car was used, all right, to move the dead body. What? You killed the victim at some distant location, Officer Meekins. And then you used the blue Batmobile to transport it all the way here. Now you're coming with me.
But it wasn't me, sir, the killer, sir. It wasn't me, sir.
Agent Lang, wait. What do you want now? We still don't know where the real scene of the crime is. You can't say we know all the facts of this case, let alone the truth. I told you, truth smoosh. Can't speak. I couldn't care less. Truth smooth. All our job is to catch the crook. You'll find out your precious truth after you arrest this guy and take him in. That's the job of you prosecutors in your fancy courts with your logic. As for us, we don't have that kind of time to waste. You boorish buffoon. I think you need to leave.
What?
We need to get the body to autopsy, and you guys are getting in the way.
You would interfere with another one of my investigations.
Hey, now, let's not forget who holds the actual authority to conduct investigations here. I'm afraid the one doing interrupting is you, my ignorant little pretty boy. Owned. Now be a good fancy boy and get out of my sight if you don't. I'll arrest you for obstruction of justice. What a jackass. Hey, finally, the to be continued mark. Been waiting to see when that's gonna pop up. Yeah, I'm impressed about how well this game's playing on my laptop now. Well, I still have no idea who the killer is. Chased out like a pair of peasants.
Mr. Edgeworth?
Yes, Kay?
There's something even thieves should never steal.
Do you know what that is? You really shouldn't steal anything. However, I'll bite. What shouldn't a thief steal?
A life. It's too heavy of a burden on your soul to get away with ever.
That's something we can agree on. Well said, Kay. No matter what we may try, murder is the one crime that can never truly be hidden. And I intend to prove that by my own hands. When I apprehend the murderer myself.
Alright, and I'm going to work extra hard to be a good assistant. Let's go.
I still never said you could be my assistant. I'm just going to have to drop the issue. The first thing we should do is locate the real scene of the murder. I'm guessing it's the haunted house.
Mr. Edgeworth!
Detective Gumshoe.
Mr. Edgeworth, the stadium! Hurry, sir!
Uh-oh.
This is supposed to be hush-hush, but they found a witness at the stadium.
Oh, God. I have a feeling I know who the witness is.
A witness?
You, what did you tell about leaving your assigned post?
Oh, no, it's just a regular detective. Okay.
Ah, the jig is up. Mr. Edgeworth, remember that. I'm always rooting for you, so go get him, sir.
Oh, he actually walked away this time. They didn't have to drag him.
It's not all fun and games, Kay. Now then, let's head to the stadium and meet this witness.
If it's who I think it is, I'm going to have to cry to myself.